they are promoting indigenous industries and indigenous industrialists. Whereas in most of the developing countries, so-called countries, in the pretext of foreign trade development, multinational investment, overseas investment, and the trade expansion, privatization and globalization issues, the local people are covered and they are just flaxed and flaxed in pieces. So why to catch these people trampled by the titanic feet of taxation and why to give them for some other agencies? Not only should be maintained with equal activism and equal energy. So that should be maintained. Tax harboring, that should also concentrate upon the encouragement of the local people. If there is a natural encouragement for business, natural relaxation for self-promotion, they can get more, and corruption can be reduced, not totally extirpated. It can be reduced to some extent. These are the various issues that have been dealt by various other people. And fewer excesses are there which are not easily possible because nobody will dig their own grave. So enact similar rules, if they know that they will be victimized first, so the enacting authorities will be vigilant that it is not enacted by any cost. They will be so vigilant by that. The first thing is supervision of codes. It is not that. Lot of public companies, lot of public sectors, they are having unaccounted or unsupervised accounting systems by which lot of problems are there in maintenance of the thing. Corruption becomes very easy. So what we have to do, supervise accounting in purchase, in sale of state-owned properties, in acquisition of properties, expansion, renovation, and other things, we should have a transparent supervision system, number one. And number two, it is recently known as subsidiarity. If there is ₹100 in which 10 rupees is stolen, immediately we can identify. If there are 15,000 crores of rupees in which 15 lakhs is taken, we can identify. That is known as principle of subsidiarity, which is coming in all nations. So this will make us to distribute the work system so that each and everybody is handling a conspicuous or visible amount of fund wherever a small diversion itself will become very magnified. It is not a subsidiarity, it is a rule that the government should implement that. And also benchmarking is very important. Now Peru, they have made that benchmark. What is benchmarking? Not only giving the remuneration, but also making the person to be given rewards as well as recognition for his services that will result in your person's recognition so that he will be happy. Peru, that has given competition between all government agencies. In the government of Peru, they have given competition between various companies by which each and every company is healthily promoting with a healthy competition basis. That should be done here. And a lot of other various issues like that have been promoted, and that has been stated by various other. There was one Vata Commission here, Vora Commission here, Washington Report is there, Transparency International Report is there, innumerable people there doing various other things. And also to improve the public sector to fight against oligarchy, wherein by we can get the real index of working with a business ease atmosphere, to do business at an easy and factual atmosphere, is made by an anti-oligarchical public sector size impairment. That has been also suggested by people. And now, as per the calculative study, I want to say there are three indexes which have been made. Number one is Global Corruption Barometer. Second thing is Corruption Perception Index. Third thing is the Bribe Payers Index. These three structures have been made by the research department. One is the Corruption Perception Index. Second is the Global Corruption Barometer. Like thermometer is a barometer to measure the temperature or the velocity or variability, viscosity of the contact of corruption. Then the third thing is very simple, it is a Bribe Payers Index. Likewise, there is one corporation known as the New Millennium Corporation or Challenging Millennium Corporation. They are considered to be the foremost pioneers for establishing global governance indication. What is the parameter required for the global governance? They have given six parameters, out of which the most effective and the first parameter is control of corruption. If somebody cannot control corruption, that is not good governance at all. So all of these various things are very well known. And coming to India, what we must know is number one, first we have to be individually perfect. Second, associative perfection. Third thing is local perfection. Fourth is regional or provincial perfection. Fifth thing is the national perfection, then the local perfection. We can work more on global and national issues on ideological principles. Coming on the pragmatic issues, you should be able to confront with your associates, locals and your individual. And India has been reported as the 87th nation in the 195 nations which are corrupt. India ranks the 87th place. And it has been reported by Transparency International, it is also surprising for me also. the bribe given by the truck drivers and owners itself is annually $5 million. In the report, only by the truck people, I don't know what the bus, aircraft, railways and others policy. Only by the truck owners they have given that. 50% of the society are the first hand drivers in this society. And Washington report says that 1/4 of the people in the parliament are either proved, convicted, are being tried, or accused people for other heinous crimes. It is going to be Washington report. That Washington report, they need not give it. Delhi report can give that information. You know everything. So this is the state of India. And coming to the practical point, there is something known as ethical implantation and ethical vaccination. Ethical implantation is teaching. Ethical vaccination is inducing the spiritual knowledge or ethical knowledge inside a person at the time of his impressionable age itself, so that he will be allergic to corruption and synergy to honesty. A person should be naturally, like a cow which hates flesh naturally, being a carnivorous, being a herbivorous animal, a non-carnivorous structure. Like a person who is ethically vaccinated, he will be allergic to corruption and other evils, and synergic to honesty and other valuable principles. And coming to the final section of our own mercantile structure and business ethics, there is temptation targeting, craze marketing of people, duplication, extra power publicity, dream publicity, speculative publicity. Innumerable things we are doing, adulteration, quantity reduction, quality reduction, innumerable other misbehaviors are there in that also. So the basic honesty or the basic ethical medulla oblongata of the business industry is number one, to do with consumer surplus. If anybody is extracting, that's what I used to say, the poor people, they cannot directly fight with you. It is the strength of the weak, the curse of them, the bone of them, the cry of them will affect us. Natural disasters and global recessions. So that should be some ethicism in business practice also. It is not a consumer surplus. It means they get more benefits, they feel more satisfied and benefited by our services. Instead of getting, it is not a disastrous race. It is not a disastrous race. You want to get money, you want to get more money because that is the need of the society. But get from more people, by more products, by more work in more term of years, to want to get the same thing within a shorter span, by administering unlawful means, it is very cruel and naturally brutal. So, this type of unlawful enrichment that will affect the person, affect the ethical society, economical society, also destroying that. So, what we have to do is, there are four pillars of business intelligence or business performa. Number one is, we have to take care of the consumer, exploiting anybody in the society. Nobody can be happy, harmonious, or prosperous for a longer time. Even if they are wealthy and prosperous, they will be improsperous or non-prosperous in some other grounds like health, in their generations, in their harmony and other things. It takes various other cruel forms and affect the society as well as the individual. So don't exploit anybody. Expose your desire to serve them and just bindu shekara, drop